Pathology. The changes that occur in the kidneys and ureters from the presence of calculi may be considered under three heads, viz. Retention, ulceration, and inflammation. Retention. A calculus formed in the renal pelvis may at any moment slip down and be caught at the orifice of the ureter, or any physiological or pathological narrowing in that duct. Such an impaction may be partial or complete. It is usually partial, and as the urine dammed up behind this sudden obstacle brings pressure upon it, the stone is forcibly driven into the ureter, setting up a renal colic. This is relieved by the passage of the stone into the bladder, by its slipping back into the pelvis, or by the gradual accommodation of the parts to the new conditions. If the stone remains impacted, it causes either partial retention resulting in hydronephrosis or complete retention resulting in an acute aneurysm and subsequent atrophy of the kidney, unless the obstruction is relieved. This complete retention is evinced by aneurysm, calculus aneurysm it is called, which is partial or temporary if the opposite kidney is able to continue its functions, permanent and fatal if the opposite kidney stops secreting, whether on account of reflex congestion or of bilateral calculus obstruction. Ulceration. Ulceration occurs at whatever point in the kidney, the pelvis, or the ureter a stone may rest. If the stone is small and movable, the ulceration may be insignificant. If it is large or impacted, the ulceration may be so deep and extensive that actual perforation occurs, permitting the stone to escape from the kidney, the pelvis, or the ureter into the surrounding tissues. This complication, associated as it is with urinary extravasation, is as unusual as it is grave. Ureteral stricture results from calculus impaction. Figure 78. Kidney destroyed by large branching silent calculus. The patient had pus, frequency, and tubercle bacilli. Nephrectomy for tuberculosis revealed this stone and a few minute tuberculous lesions. Inflammation. It is futile to attempt to enumerate the various lesions that may be caused by one or more stones in the various portions of the upper urinary tract. The lesions of retention, ulceration, and inflammation are combined in endless variety. There may be only localized suppuration about a small pelvic calculus, or there may be numerous calculus pockets throughout the kidney. The entire organ may be reduced to a multilocular abscess cavity filled by a great branching stone, figure 78. The kidney may be found atrophied and closely contracted around a stone that had caused complete obstruction years before. Pyonephrosis results from obstruction of the ureter by stone or stricture when there is infection. Suppuration within the organ may be associated with perinephritis from extension of the inflammation or from rupture of the sac. The ureter shows various degrees of dilatation, ureteritis, and periureteritis. The longer the disease continues, the more extensive the destruction of renal tissue and the greater the likelihood of bilateral calculus disease. The ureter. The relations of stone and ureter are four, viz. 1. The stone is simply in transit. It may catch from time to time, causing renal colic and perhaps slight temporary ureteritis and dilatation, but ultimately passes and leaves no permanent change in the canal. 2. The stone is definitely arrested. The ureter above it is dilated, about it ulcerated, below it strictured. The stone may be relatively movable at operation or fixed. As it grows, it may become encysted in a pocket in the ureter wall. 3. The ureter ruptures, A, by acute gangrene, or B, ulceration about an encysted stone. The result is usually acute retroperitoneal phlegmon, infiltration of urine, abscess, fistula. Rarely, an encysted stone escapes silently into the retroperitoneal tissue. 4. The ureter is so dilated, the stone so smooth and small, that the latter slips readily to and from the pelvis, up and down the ureter. Carcinoma. I have seen 2 cases of renal carcinoma secondary to stone. Coriel reports 9 such cases. tuberculosis, see figure 78.